is the first morning wearing my SoftStar Shoe Runamoc Dash Lites. So I thought I'd do a quick little review of these awesome modern-day moccasins. The Runamoc Dash is a newer version of SoftStar Shoes Runamoc. It's a slightly tighter-fitting shoe and a slightly different style as well. Now, I've ordered the Runamoc Dash Lite, which, as you can see, has the perforated leather. And so that allows a little bit more breathability and comfort if you have sweaty feet like mine. So I ordered these shoes during their annual clearance sale, in which they sell off their custom-made or their DIY moccasins. And so these shoes were not made specifically for my feet, although they happened to be exactly the size I was looking for, but just keep that in mind. I really like having a well-fitting shoe, even in these minimal shoes where your feet are supposed to splay out. And what I mean by that is I want it well-fitting in the instep, so around my foot. I don't like the shoe to be flopping around. I don't like it slipping off to the side if I need to make a sharp turn. I'm using these mostly for running, so that's why I like a good fit. And the great thing is that these Runamocs fit extremely well. I happen to order the narrow version of the shoe because I have very slender feet. And as you can see, there's even quite a bit of extra laces that I could use to tighten this down in case that leather stretches a bit. This perforated leather is incredibly comfortable. It's really form-fitting. And I'm hoping that that's going to be even more apparent as I continue to wear it. Now, the one downside, as you can see, is that the toe box, while it is very wide, it is a very odd shape, or maybe my foot is slightly deformed. But as you can see, there's nearly an inch of space on the right side of my, on the inside of my feet. And you can see that on my other foot as well. There's just a whole lot of extra space on this inside, and so it appears as though the shape of the shoe really curves around towards the medial side, or the inside, whereas my feet tend to be extremely straight. I'm hoping that with time the leather is going to form. That the secondary problem is that it really causes my small toes to really get crunched up against the side of the shoe, which is not what you want in the middle of a shoe, minimalist shoe. You want your toes to be able to really splay out, and they just can't do that. The other thing about this model, this was a DIY again, and so the colors were customized by whoever had ordered it originally, but they also chose to go with the Vibram sole, and this is a great sole for trail running, which is primarily why I got this shoe. So it does have a Vibram sole. I didn't read clearly into this. I was actually looking for a leather sole, but I'm okay that this one came with a Vibram sole. Now this is I think it's a 10 millimeter Vibram sole, and what that means is it provides quite a lot of cushioning. So walking on pavement, it's quite comfortable, and that is a nice thing. But I'm not sure that that's so much of a good thing when, in a minimal shoe, what you're really looking for is a good feel for the ground. And in this shoe, I don't feel the ground as much in other minimalist shoes. But it certainly is comfortable for walking around all day. So that is the SoftStar Runamoc Lite Dash, or Runamoc Dash Lite. And so far I'm liking it. It's incredibly comfortable. But again, the shape of it doesn't quite fit my foot. I haven't found a shoe that does. And again, these were DIYs that somebody else ordered and I got on clearance. And so I'm pretty happy with them, but they are not the ideal shoe just yet. I am looking forward to, in the future, doing my own DIY with SoftStar shoes and see how those fit. So there you go. Happy barefooting.